Fault of dominance in a husband.
There are some men who run away from home because they get tired of their wives. What is that?
No. Why should we become a runaway? We are pure souls. What is the need for us to become runaways? We have to settle all matters with equanimity with our wives.
I want to settle everything with equanimity. But how do I go about doing that? Should I accept it in my mind as a past account?
You cannot settle matters by just doing that alone. Settling with equanimity means you have to make a phone call to the other person's soul. You must notify her soul. You must admit and accept your mistakes to that soul. You have to repent strongly and ask for forgiveness.
Do I have to do pratikraman? That is, Dada's prescribed technique of confession, repentance, asking for forgiveness, and vowing never to repeat the mistake, even if someone insults me?
Do pratikraman only when they insult you, not when they praise you. When you do pratikraman, feelings of hatred for that person will not arise at all. On the contrary, you will have a positive effect on him. In the first stage of your pratikraman, you will become aware of the fact that you do not have any abhorrence or negative feelings for him. Later on, the other person will also feel the positive effects of your pratikraman.
Does it reach his soul?
Yes, definitely. His soul will nudge his pudgal, that is the physical body. There's a phone call for you. This pratikraman of ours is meant to destroy aggressive thoughts, speech and acts.
Do we have to do a lot of pratikraman?
If you want to build a house quickly, you will have to employ more builders. It is fine if you cannot do pratikraman for outsiders. But you must do a lot of pratikraman for those around you and those who are close to you. For the people in your home, you should keep the intention that these people are born close to me, they live together with me, and someday they should take advantage of this wonderful science of liberation. A man once came to me and said, "Dada, I am married now, but I do not like my wife." I asked him his reason, and he told me he did not like her because she walked with a limp. So I asked him, "Does your wife like you?" He replied, "Dada, I am a likable person. I am handsome, educated, I earn good money, and I do not have any deformities." I told him, "Then the fault is yours. What kind of a mistake did you make to deserve a limping wife like her, and what good karma did she have to get a great husband like you? Listen here. It is all your own doing that is coming back to you. So then, why are you looking at faults in her? Suffer the fruits of your past mistakes with equanimity and do not make any new mistakes." The man understood this and his life, which was on the verge of ruins, became harmonious.
Husbands, act according to Dada's vision.
What should I do when my wife says she doesn't want my parents to live with us or that I am not to call them?
Work through it by making her understand. Do it democratically. Call her parents and take really good care of them.
If I have to choose between my parents and my wife, whom should I listen to first?
Improve your relationship with your wife to the extent that she herself will tell you to take care of your parents. Why are you behaving this way? You should say a few negative things about your parents to your wife to make her feel that you are in her favor. But what do men say instead? "No one has a mother like mine. You better not say anything to her." Then, if your wife gets upset, you should tell her, "Mother's nature has become that way. Do not mind her. Forgive her." The Indian mind has a propensity towards changing in the wrong direction. Do you know there are some men who make their wives their guru?
Yes, I do.
It is not advisable to make your wife your guru. If you do, you will put your parents and all your family members in difficulty, including yourself. There will be times when you will have to play with her also, but you will not be able to do that if you make her your boss. This does not happen to those who come to me. With my Gnan, their life together becomes filled with harmony. All subtle internal violence disappears. All they think about is how to make each other happy. You have to be careful and compromising, especially with a new wife. If everything is new, then you have to help her adjust. If the wife sulks on the first day and you get upset, nothing good will come about. If she sulks, pacify her and tell her the two of you are one. Try to appease her in this manner. What happens if you both start shouting? Shouldn't you know how to deal with your wife?
Some ladies get tired of the routine house chores. When you ask them to do something, they come up with all kinds of excuses, such as I'm tired, my head hurts, my back hurts.
Start in the morning by saying to her, "My dear, you are tired today. Why don't you take a break and rest?" This will energize her. She will reply, "No, you be quiet and sit down. I will take care of it." We should be masters in the art of convincing others to do work.
When we are driving, she tells me how to drive, where to take a turn, when to slow down, and when to apply the brakes. She's always nagging. Drive this way and drive that way.
So, leave the driving to her. Then there will be no hassle.
Then she will say she does not have the courage to drive.
Then ask her, why is she interfering with your driving? Ask her if your driving is hurting her in any way. Tell her that the only reason she gets away with her criticisms is because you are her husband. Ask her if she would criticize the chauffeur the same way. She knows that if she did, she would tell her to be quiet or get out, putting her in a predicament.
If you do not take the wife's side, there will be a fight.
Correct. And there is nothing wrong in doing so. If you take her side, only then will you have a peaceful night. Otherwise, how would you be able to sleep? In these kinds of situations, you should not use your intellect as a lawyer.
We should not side with the neighbors when they fight with our wives, should we?
No, in all disputes, you should always take the side of your wife, not the neighbors. Even if your wife is at fault, take care of the people in your own home first. Even if your wife is guilty, you should defend her. There, you do not need to look for justice and accuse her of wrongdoing. You have to eat and sleep here only. You should plead the case in support of your own family.
How can we tell whether the other party has been satisfied? The other party may be satisfied, but what if there is harm in it for them?
That is not your lookout. If there is harm in it for them, it is their lookout. You should take into consideration what is good or bad for others. But do you really have the ability to do so? You are not able to see what is good or bad for your own self. So why are you looking for the good or the bad for others? Each individual looks for what is in his own best interest according to his own capacity. There should not be any conflict in trying to do good for the other person.
When we make an effort to ending a conflict with someone, and we know that the result is not going to be satisfactory, what should we do?
The end result may be anything, but all you have to do is make a decision to put an end to it. Decide to settle with equanimity. Then, do not be concerned with whether there is closure or not. It will happen. If not today, then someday. If it, that is your karmic account, is sticky, you may take 2 or 3 or 5 years. Karmic accounts with your wife, children, and parents are very sticky and complex, and therefore, closure with them will take longer. These relatives are always with us. Here, settlement will take time. But if you have made the decision that you do want to settle with equanimity, then one day it will settle. It will come to an end.
Unwind the strings of bondage with wife in this manner.
One day a man came to me crying, so I asked him what was wrong. He told me, "My young wife died recently and I cannot stop thinking about her. I have 2 young children." I then asked how long they had been married. exactly 12 years today, he replied. So then I asked him if he would have had feelings for her had he met her on a bus 12 and a half years ago, to which he replied, no. Don't they sit the bride and groom under the chori that is a canopy under which the Hindu marriage ceremony is conducted during the wedding ceremony? As he sits in the chori, he looks at the woman across from him and says to himself, yes, this is my wife. When he tells himself this, he winds the first knot of my wife. Countless twists of my wife, my wife, my wife begin to accumulate within him. From the moment he sat down under the chori, he kept winding the knots of my wife in this manner. And that winding continues till this moment. So just imagine how many knots he has wound. How is he going to unwind these knots? These are the knots of mamta, that is attachment. I told him that from that moment on, he would have to keep reciting, not mine, not mine, not mine. He would have to keep telling himself, this woman is not mine, she is not mine. This way, all the knots he had tied would unravel. If you have tied 50,000 knots by saying mine, 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 then by saying not mine, not mine, not mine 50,000 times over, you will free yourself from your attachment. What is this meaningless obsession? So then, what did he do? For 3 days, he kept saying, she is not mine, she is not mine, she is not mine. And by doing that, he was able to stop crying. His grief vanished. All these are merely knots that we have entwined, and it is because of these knots that we suffer. All such suffering is false. Do you understand what I'm saying? Now, who is going to show you such a simple, straightforward way? All day long, you should continue doing pratikraman for your husband. When you do this, 6 months' worth of ill feelings will be destroyed in just one day. Even if you do it for half a day, at least 3 months will be cleared. Did you have any attachment with your husband before you got married? No. So when did this attachment start? It was decided when the two of you sat across from each other under the wedding canopy and you thought to yourself, this is my husband. He's a little plump and dark-skinned. He too decided, this is my wife. From that moment onwards, these knots of my started. This film has been going on for 15 years and it will only unwind if you say, he is not mine, he is not mine. Only then this false attachment will end. These opinions have arisen from the time of your marriage. Prejudices of he's like this, he's like that have taken hold. Were they ever there before? Now, you have to decide. No matter what he is like, he's the only one for me. You yourself had selected him. Is it appropriate for you to ask for a different husband now?